Hi, welcome back to the Cosmic Classroom. We'll now see what it would be like to visit a black hole. So strange things happen as you get close to a black hole. Let's see what happens. First of all, let me ask you a question. Would you rather visit a low-mass black hole or a high-mass black hole? You know you would die if you got too close, right? So you think you would survive a few more seconds visiting a high-mass black hole or a low-mass black hole? So let's see. Let's imagine two black holes, one that has the mass of the sun and the other that has three times the mass of the sun. Well, a black hole with the mass of the sun will have a radius of 3 kilometers, a Schwarzschild radius, which is the event horizon, and the 3 solar mass black hole would have a radius of 9 kilometers. And now let's imagine a penguin. And the penguin is deciding which one to visit. His first idea is, well, I don't really want to die so soon, so I'm going to visit the low-mass one. It's probably safer. So there he goes. He's visiting the low-mass one. And as he goes, he gets stretched. And he's not very happy there, right? He's completely stretched. He's thin and tall. He's feeling more, greater pull in its feet than in its head. That's why it's being stretched. This is the tidal effect. And if you're not sure about the tidal effects, go look back at when I talked about tides, because I referred about black holes too in tides. So the penguin, the poor penguin, gets stretched. This is called spaghettification also. So then the penguin decides to try again, as if he could. Let's just imagine for a minute I could try again, right? It couldn't, but let's see. So the two penguins, the two experiences are as follow. The penguin, when it gets close to the event horizon of the 3 solar mass, the 2 solar mass black hole, is less stretched. It suffers less of a tidal effect than when it was at the event horizon of the 1 solar mass one. Notice that the feet, in this case, are being less attracted than they were before. The head is also being less attracted than it was before. And if you don't believe me, just remember that the force of gravity depends on the mass, and it's inversely proportional to the radius square. So the radius is more important than the mass. Okay, so because it's farther from the sun, farther from the black hole, the pull of gravity also decreases. But what's really important here is not the forces themselves, but the difference in forces, because that's what's stretching that penguin. If the force in the head and the force in the feet were the same, it would just be falling fast and it wouldn't be stretched. But it's the fact that they are different in the head and in the feet that causes the tidal effect. So, if you're still wondering, better to visit a high-mass black hole than a low-mass one. But there's more missing from this picture, all right? Now I added another penguin here. This is the observer penguin. It came in a spaceship with the other penguin. But it's smart enough to know to stay away from the black hole and just observe while the full one goes into the black hole. So we're going to analyze this picture here and try to see a more complete picture. But before I do that, I need to explain some things that happen near a massive object, near a black hole. One of the things that happen is that when light is leaving a strong gravitational field, it gets redshifted. So imagine that a penguin was holding a flashlight and pointing that flashlight to its friend sitting in the spacecraft. The light, as it tries to leave the black hole, you can think about it as it gets tired. It loses energy. It becomes redshifted. So as it's trying to get away from this object that's attracting it, it gets redder and redder and redder. So if the flashlight is, for example, emitting visible light, at 100 kilometers from the black hole, it will be emitting infrared. At 10,000, that light will be radio. It will be redshifted. If the flashlight is emitting in the X-ray, then maybe the penguins sitting far away will see it indivisible. But the fact is that the light gets redshifted. Another way of seeing that redshift is by looking at the space-time diagram again. So here we have the black hole. This is similar to the space-time diagram that I showed for the sun before. And the light is trying to climb out of this hole, gets tired, loses energy, gets redshifted. This is called the gravitational redshift. A consequence of the gravitational redshift is that time, there is time dilation and the space contracts. Now let's see if you can follow that. The penguin is near a massive star and sends a signal, light of a certain frequency. And the penguin decides that 1 second is the time between the two crests here. It's the wavelength of the wavelength of light. And it decides that this is defined as 1 second. Now, the penguin sitting far away from the black hole will receive this light sometime later, and the light will have been stretched. It's redshifted. So, the penguin that's sitting here counts 1 second in its clock, but a full wavelength has not passed yet. So the penguin here would have to count a bigger amount of time to see the same thing that was referred to as 1 second by the penguin near the massive star. So a consequence of gravitational redshift is that the time as seen by the observer far away is dilated. It looks like this penguin here is taking forever to send the two peaks of light. Okay? Takes more than a second. So, if they had agreed that the penguin would arrive there and send light, a peak of light every 1 second, this guy here is thinking that the guy far away is thinking he's not really his job, he's lazy, he's just standing it once every 2 seconds. Okay, so it will see the guy as slow. So the consequence is that the one that's in falling, the amount of time that passes is smaller than the amount of time that passes for someone that's observing. So let's see what really happens. Well, let's complete the picture. What happens is that, first of all, the penguin that's falling, it gets redder because of the gravitational redshift, right? So the penguin will be observed. This is how this one here will see. The penguin that's staying still will see this one getting redder and redder and redder because it will be redshifted. And also, it will notice that this penguin is taking forever to do anything. It's really slow. It's lazy. It's taking forever to fall into the black hole. And it's taking forever to send any signal to him waiting in the spacecraft. So, time will be passing differently. This penguin here will continue to be young, while this one is aging and waiting for light to arrive. So what the old penguin that stays have to wait forever to get any signal from the young penguin. And it never sees the penguin really fall into that black hole. Okay. So very funny things happen when you get close to a black hole. And if you haven't figured that out yet, you can't really visit the black hole, not this close. You're much more likely to move into it. And for the penguin that's falling in it, everything happens fast. He doesn't notice anything. It will take a fraction of a second. But for the penguin that's observing, it never sees its friend really falling into the black hole. It just becomes redder and redder and redder, and it freezes in space like this. And that's what I wanted to tell you about black holes. I hope it helped. See you next time.